What's up, everybody? Fatty Maddie back with more Elden Ring here. So, this boss fight is pretty rough. I'm only at 69 strength, but... Yeah, it's a rough one. My damage is okay. Everything seems to be okay with the exception of getting away from the one move Malenia has. It's like a multi-hit move. I haven't figured out how to like actually dodge it completely. So, and if I'm not full on health, it pretty much just kills you. So been using the mimic. It's been going okay, but the damage isn't an issue. It's staying alive. That's the one that I have no idea how to dodge yet. That one's pretty rough too, but... Got her to second stage, actually. Wow. I've not been able to do this by myself yet, so far. like I said, this fight's it's rough. I took a couple days off from Elden Ring, because... Yeah. I couldn't even help finish it with someone else. The summoner would always get killed.
Wait.
I've never actually seen this until just now. Pretty crazy cutscene.
You will witness true horror.
My mimic's just... Yeah, he's almost dead. No, 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 no! Don't! That's the move right there. I told you, it pretty much is a guaranteed death for me. My guy's just too fat. That sucks. I think I can do it. I think I can actually stagger her out of that move. With the ruined greatsword weapon art. I'm gonna let my summon take tank. And yeah. Maybe he'll tank. Come on. I'm not gonna get. Well, I was gonna say I'm not gonna get greedy. Second phase, she's gonna come in hot. Oh my gosh. Pop that. Pop that. Going in. Back up! Get her, mimic! Smash her! Smash her down! No! Yay! This fight is fun. So much fun. No, it's not bad. It's a good fight. Where's my mimic at? Let's go, boy. Second phase, here we go. Dodge! I gotta figure out how to dodge out of that. That rot ticks hard. Holy crap, does it tick hard. I really don't want to put boluses on either, because then I'll get even more confused and I'll eat a bolus when I'm supposed to be healing. Come on, buddy, let's go. Not a good start. Almost down. Get her.
Strength.
All right, got her.
Extraordinary. The mark of a true lord.
All right, Malenia's great rune.
Oh, dear Mikola.
Heck yeah.
Oh, dearest Mikola, my brother. I'm sorry. I finally met my match.
Remembrance of the Rot Guts. Nice. Sweet, did it. Going all in on strength. We're gonna get strength to 80. Oh, that's a big flower. I did go ahead and do Millicent's questline. So her questline, after you find her in, let's see, it's, where is it? Oh, It's this one, the Erdtree Grazing Hill. She's like right here somewhere. After you find her there and give her the prosthesis, she moves over to the windmill heights after you kill the god skin here. She'll be like right by the windmill as you come back to the Grace. Once you talk to her there, she moves over to here, the ancient Snow Valley ruins. She's just right beside the Grace again, like just right beside it. Once you talk to her there, she moves from here over to the Hallig Tree prayer room, right? After at the prayer room, after you talk to her there, she'll move near the drainage channel. And you have to kill the ulcerated tree spirit there, which I already did in a previous video. And then once you do that, you come back to the drainage channel, Grace, you rest, and then come back over towards where the ulcerated tree is. That's much better damage. Those 2 points helped a lot, actually. So you come over here, and there'll be 2 summon signs here. Up here on the hill. There's a yellow and a red. Like, right here and here somewhere. You'll see them. You'll see the yellow one from over there, actually. You can either help her, or you can invade her. So if you betray her, you help her sister's killer. If you help her, then you help her fight her sisters. There's 4 of them. She'll do most of the work. She's got that move that Millicent does, or Malenia does, that big slashy move that kills me every time. And that'll pretty much wipe out most of them. After that, after you kill them, then you come down here, and you can talk to her down here. And she says that she's removed the needle and that she's gonna let rot take over and kill her, and she doesn't want you to watch, basically. And then after you talk to her, she'll give you gives you a charm, the Rotten Winged Sword insignia, which greatly raises attack power with successive hits or attacks. You get that. After you get that, you go back to the drainage channel and then come back over here where she'll be laying here dead. And then from there, you can pick up the needle. So yeah. A little bit spoilery, because I guess the needle helps you get out of an ending, but with that, I think the Hallig Tree is done. As far as I know, the Hallig Tree is done. So we're gonna come back over to here. And I'm going to explore this So yeah, there is a few quests that are very hard to figure out. That's one of them. Got some crabs down here. But really, I mean, that's kind of the only thing I've looked up, so. Look, I'm killing your babies! Your babies are dying! I killed them. What you doing? Nothing? I'm gonna kill these ones! This one's like, urgh! Oh, I probably needed them to smash this. No, that might do it. Mr. Octopus, come down. Or Mrs. Octopus, whatever you are. Yeah, come on over here. Can you smash this? Let me see. Can you do it? Oh, yeah. Knock it off. Land octopus ovary. So we have a sword stone cave there. Just a bunch of smoldering butterflies. Oh, great worm of Phaedrix. Hey, it's another. The lava damage. Jiminy Christmas. The lava took like 3/4 of my health. Alrighty, oh well. What is that? A piece of loot? It is a piece of loot up there. Go away. No one cares about you. No one cares about you either. I'm sure this worm will slap you around silly. You know how to do? Oh, do anything else. It works.
Basically just one-shot me. What the frick?
I like how after my guy died, he's like, because he was on fire. Like, you're dead. You can't make noise. At least that's generally how that stuff works, you know. Once you die, you're kind of like, oh, that's a death fall. Yay! Didn't went up there. I thought I could jump over there, but I couldn't stop in time after I realized it. And I think I just lost 189,000 runes, something like that. Stuff up here is worth a crap ton, so 189,000 is pretty easy to get back. That magma worm is probably worth 100, if not more. Oh, you dickhead. Oh, it's great worm, Theodrix. Theodorix. I can fall on you. Ow. Ow. I'm gonna go into the tunnel thingy so I don't have to go as far to get to this thing every time I die, because apparently I'm gonna die a lot there. I'm almost thinking about getting rid of these two great swords too and going back to like a frost build with the great sword and the Zweihander. Like, I like this sword, I really do. Not so much of a fan of the grafted blade, but the other one's really good. Don't mind me. These two in here and be on my way. Cave of the Forlorn. Oh, jeez. There's a dragon in here. All right, I think I'm gonna end it here just because, we're already at 30 minutes and I struggled to kill this thing. I don't think I'm gonna kill it in the next fight. So, what the frick is down there? That's trippy. Anyway, if you guys like this video, I hope you do. Be sure to hit that like button for me. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you're new. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one.